Okay, I'm back.
And go over there.
But Drake got Drake said it.
Okay, I'm back.
Check again. Welcome to episode 17 of Such a Lineup Park. Oh, it's Such a Lineup Podcast.
What? No.
Hey, Matt.
What's going on?
Come here. Ain't nobody put Brandon. We have a meeting on when we have a meeting. Oh, we lost one. We have a meeting when we have a meeting. You ain't put Brandon up there, Holmes. He won't talk about Brandon all day.
Well, you have a meeting on Thursday, but you met on Friday without advance notice.
Thursday was the 4th of July for us Americans. You Frenchmen, you Louisiana Frenchmen.
We only take the day off. We don't care about the holiday.
Checking in next to me, who I got in the yellow shirt, because sometimes he really don't like yellow shirt, Dallas Cowboys. Who you is? Oh my God. Yo. My man, excuse me, sir.
Hey, you sound like a transformer.
Well, you sound like nothing. You sound like a mime. Come on, run it. Well, who are you?
You ain't paid that internet bill yet.
Who are you? Your homeboy don't want to keep jumping in. That. What is your name, sir?
You talking to me?
No, I'm talking to your homeboy.
It's the boy Clutch, aka Domino, here in the flesh, baby.
Next to Domino, I got who?
The people's champ, the number one seed. Go Celtics. Back to back coming and loading up.
Under him, no Diddy, I got who?
It's your boy DSPN checking in one time. I know it's been a minute, but I'm back, baby.
Special guest, welcome.
It's been 1,000 minutes. It's been 1,000,000 minutes. In the middle of representing Brandon James, we got who?
Hey, Unpredictable. Hey, I'm going to start changing my name to the number one LeBron truth teller / that's what they call hating. Because guess what? I just call it like I see it.
Well, and down bottom last but not least, first on earth, but first to us. Who we got?
This is your favorite gangster, Trigger Man Joe. And you're now tuning in to Set Your Line Up Podcast. Like, subscribe, tell a friend, tell an enemy, tell your coworker. Welcome, welcome, welcome. We welcome your thoughts, your emojis, and suggestions. I hope you're ready for a great show because I'm not. We're going to have fun, though.
You not ready for a great show?
No, I ain't ready.
Dorito Joe in the building.
Yo. Yum.
Hi, everybody doing, man? Good to see DSPN. If you just started watching the show for a month, you might not know who this is. You might not know him, but you seen him on the intro. How you been doing, DSPN?
Man, it's been good, man. Been busy, but it's been good. It's paying the bills, I'll put it like that.
Busy is good.
We're going to start paying the bill one day, and then we're going to have some talks.
Yeah, we're going to get our water cut on soon. Get our water cut on real soon.
Oh, yeah. Unpredictable. You got anything, man? Anything you got to say?
Hey, I'm just living a dream. I'm just kicked back watching people shoot 2 for 9, trying to prove that they still good. That's all. Sometimes you just got to sit back, relax, and let nature take its course. And right now, he's right on course because he shot 26% at USC. So why did I expect anything different?
Hey, and you know what's crazy is, I had high hopes for LeBron James Jr. yesterday. His over-under was 8 points. I took him over. I just knew he was gonna be better than what we done saw and who we thought he was.
And people, if you just start watching the show, if you just start watching the show and that man just told you what he told you, that is him. That is DSBN best bet. So,
like I just like, you know, you want to think better of everybody. You want to think the best for people, but people have sold you their best. Believe it. We have seen the best from Bronny James. We're not going to see no better.
I was thinking the best last week, one of y'all. He'll be here.
Hey, you know what the funny part is? I feel bad for the young man because this is orchestrated by his daddy. Sometimes this is what we don't understand. And this is one thing I learned from education. Sometimes we got to let these kids fill their own dreams out and stop putting unwanted pressure on these kids. And I just feel bad for the young man because he has to perform. But I also say this. When people say, oh, he had a heart attack last year, I just say this one thing with all due respect to health. You think people have a better quality of life off a heart attack or they get a little worse? Like, you act like the man tore his knee up and it was going to be healed better than ever. The man had a heart attack. I mean, by the time that man get 30, he can't even take
his stupid hair.
I don't know, man. Hey, get this young man off. Let's talk about somebody who earned a spot instead of his daddy giving it. Let's go to Quincy. We don't want to talk about somebody who daddy giving him spots and shooting 2 for 9. He did better just playing defense and passing.
Well, give it up for the new producer of the show, Unpredictable. Unpredictable. Let's talk about Quincy. Hold on, Holmes. Don't,
you ain't want the job anyway.
Hey, you the
moderator. Shout out to Quincy Wilson.
Some work, man. Let's do it. You want to take my claps? No, Diddy. And Unpredictable want to introduce the segment, but we will start the show. I let him get all his hate out. You know, you gotta get that out early. Happy 4th of July weekend, representing people. Quincy Wilson makes the relay team, like Clutch, aka Domino, said that he probably would. Clutch, what's your take on Quincy making the team?
Well, I think it's good for him as far as experience-wise, you know, being around a lot of, you know, track veterans, learning the ins and outs and, you know, what to do and what not to do, maybe some different training methods. So I think this would be good for him. And it'll be an experience that he'll never forget as the youngest person ever to be on an Olympic team. So it's good for him.
Sydney went on the Olympic team at 16?
Who?
Sydney, the light bright.
The Hurt Love.
The Hurt Love.
She's been breaking records since she was 16.
Oh, but she wasn't on the Olympic.
Okay. I don't know if she was on at 16 or not.
No, Quincy is the youngest by date.
Okay.
We're not saying that she's not, but he at least beat her in age.
Oh, okay, because I don't know. I don't know. I started watching Olympics in 88. Great picture, my boy. Unpredictable. You got any takes on this young man and his feet?
Be honest with you, I'm proud of the young man. He grinded, he worked, and for him to reach a feat like that from because his body hasn't physically matured yet to even, you know, get to that point. So to me, you know, all kudos to this young man. He worked hard. He didn't have nobody to, you know, kind of force the issue and say don't draft him. He just went out there. He did what he had to do. He didn't come in. He didn't finish in eighth place, and we interviewing him talking about what they gonna do 4 years from now. And that's how you're supposed to do. And here's the thing: I have no problem with a person boasting and bragging, but you gotta win first. So you know, to me, kudos to this young man. I see a bright future, and just looking for bigger and better things from him. No Diddy, as he continues to represent the USA. So proud of him. Hats off. No complaints. No issues. Way to work.
Anybody else got any congratulations for this young man? Go ahead, champ.
I'm glad he has the opportunity to go pro. I'm glad he decided to go back to he gonna go back to school and finish up. Glad he got an NIL deal. New Balance gave him an NIL deal, so he ain't in no rush to try to outlive his whatever his age is. And then I'm glad that he's getting that experience, because now he can challenge some of those great track and field guys' records when they got 3 or 4, 5 or 6 Olympic gold medals. So by him starting at this early age, if he can go in and get one clocked in at the 4x400, then that'll get him a good start on trying to catch the all-time great, the all-time record lead, you know. So
also, it's news that, you know, from a credited track coach, that the way that Quincy runs, if he can form the way that he runs, he's a possible shaving off at least a second from his quickest time.
And what did we do for news the past 3 weeks? Look how inspirational that was. We know that. See, that's that gap. That's the Ben man. Know that you can shave a second and all that. But we appreciate to have you in DSPN. Anybody else?
Go ahead, Joe.
Go ahead, man. Get your one in.
I want to say I like the fact that they put him with the team. So that way, this is not, because correct me if I'm wrong, he's on the relay.
The 4x4. Yeah.
So this gives him a chance not to be singled out specifically in an open 400, where, you know, he's still going against grown men and professionals that's been training probably about as old as he is. So he's not going to be just right there having to do it all on his own and kind of, you know, destroying some of his confidence. He's with a team where everybody has to work together. And I think the third heat is usually the slowest one, whoever the so-called slowest person is or something like that. He's going to be around people. The group of people that he's going to be with is going to be people that's around his same speed, so to speak. So it's not like he's going head to head with the top 8 fastest people and, you know, just losing confidence. So I like the fact that they did mix him in, so it's not all the pressure on him.
Good take. Yeah.
Unlike somebody I know that put pressure on their son all the time. But go ahead.
Salute to the young man, Quincy. It's one thing to have a dream, and it's a totally different thing to live out a dream. And, you know, Martin Luther King had the famous speech, you know, one day hopefully be not judged by the color of our skin, but the content of our character. I have a dream today. So this young man is living out a dream. I don't even know if we had dreams and aspirations when we were 16. And if we did, it's probably nothing about saying I'm going to be in the Olympics. And that day has arrived for Quincy, and it's going to be a great experience, great competition. Get to see Paris, step on land that probably none of us on the show has ever been on. Is Paris in France? I don't know. Is Paris and France the same thing? that's a whole note for another day. But I'm excited about the young man's future. And like D was talking, if he shave a point, I think the record for the 400 is 43 something. So the guy, man, if he stays where he's at and get the form correct, hit them weights, get strong, the dude finna break all the records. Man, he's 16 years old, unless he doesn't max out, which I think that's highly impossible.
Yeah, back when you were 16, dreams was being the first man on the moon and
ain't nobody never been to the moon, man.
Well, we can still dream.
Yeah, I ain't got no dreams.
What do you want to be, little trigger man? I want to be
myself being married, having kids, a house. I ain't see none of that. To be honest, none of that.
And a star of a star of a soon to be conglomerate sports podcast.
Get the live straight.
But look, shout out to the state of Maryland for Quincy Wilson and And shout out the state of Maryland. They lost one of their natives over the weekend. Shout out to Kyrie Jackson, family and friends, former Alabama defensive back, Oregon, and was drafted by the Vikings. Shout out to those of the family and friends and fans that are dealing with the loss in an automobile accident. So we just you know, keep in mind when you're leaving, when you're getting in your cars and stuff, you know, stay prayed up and try to stay safe. But thoughts and prayers for everybody involved in that. Now we will kick it to DSPN. Very much so. Our resident WNBA. He has a way with the ladies, so I guess that's why he's our WNBA.
Don't tell him that. Don't tell him that. Don't lie on me like that.
Oh yeah.
Okay.
Lady Love, Cool James.
So the WNBA.
My bad. I'm sorry. My bad. I'm tripping. Let me let this young lady bring you in first.
Least and here it is. So this is Team USA. We already knew which players are going to be on that team. What we were waiting for was which players are going to play against them in the WNBA All-Star Game. And those names have been revealed. Here is Team WNBA. Here's who made the team. Dewana Bonner, Aaliyah Boston, Caitlin Clark, Alicia Gray, Derica Hamby, Brianna Jones, Jonquel Jones, Kayla McBride, Kelsey Mitchell, Arike Gumbawale, Neka Ogumike, and Angel Reese. Go ahead and leave me a comment and let me know what you think about this team. So here's a better close-up of Team WNBA. Caitlin Clark of the Indiana Fever and Angel Reese of the Chicago Sky were the only two rookies that were named to the WNBA All-Star Game. There are three players from the same team that made the roster, which was Aaliyah Boston, Caitlin Clark, and Kelsey Mitchell. They all play for the Indiana Fever. You may be wondering why Derica Hamby is on the roster if she's going to the Paris Olympics, and that's because she's playing on the 3-on-3 team and not the 5-on-5 team. There's two players from the Connecticut Sun on the team, Dewana Bonner and Brianna Jones. And of course, I love seeing Arike Ogunbowale on this team. If you didn't know, the last time it was Team WNBA versus Team USA. Arike was on Team WNBA and they beat Team USA and Arike won MVP. And then I also love seeing players that don't get talked about enough. The Atlanta Dreams, Alicia Gray, Jonquel Jones from New York Liberty, Kayla McBride from the Minnesota Lynx, and Neka Ogumike from the Seattle Storm. Make this roster so that more WNBA fans can be introduced to them. 2024 WNBA All-Star Game will take place on Saturday, July 20th at 8:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time in Phoenix, Arizona, and it will air on ABC.
Thank you, nice young lady. DSPN, figurize what she just said for me.
So, of course, we've heard all the chatter on Caitlin Clark not making Team USA. The WNBA has potentially lost out on millions and blah, blah, blah. We've heard all of that. So the WNBA has decided to bring back something that they've done before, which is have the All-Star Game featuring Team USA versus said All-Stars that did not make Team USA. And it'll be a regular game. It's going to be highly competitive compared to NBA All-Star Game, because these women got something to prove and they kind of want to go out and show some. And it kind of looks, it gives a bad look. Let me not say bad. It gives a negative look if Team USA go out and lose in a competitive match to Team WNBA.
True. Anybody can comment on that? Because I'm trying to find out which one of y'all got it sounding like a robot in here. And I find out.
We got the elevator music in the background.
I understand that. But somebody... What is that, Clint?
I hope Caitlin Clark drop about 30 or 40 on the USA team.
You want to bet? Hello.
I said I hope.
You want to bet that the WNBA team win over the
I said that on the last thing, man.
You think they're going?
I want the All Stars to win. I don't want Team USA to win.
Check it.
Oh, you gonna take the Olympic team?
Yeah, we'll talk.
Okay,
I got the hot take, man. I got the hot take.
Go ahead, Trigger Man Joe.
Can't believe ain't nobody put two of the two together and got four. Okay, originally I was very hard on Caitlin Clark initially, and I'm starting to change my mind.
No, I'm changing my mind.
And you know, she's the first.
Hey, rookie. Yo, that's crazy. It's hard on Kayla Clark. Is that no Diddy?
Well, no Diddy at all. Walking out.
By AB takes is a no Diddy. Right, by normal right. people takes, it ain't a no Diddy.
Right. So here's what I came up with. Well, she just got the triple-double, first rookie to get a triple-double, and a lot of teammates then celebrated, the coaches in the locker room, this and that or whatever. But the point I want to get across to the audience is I think Caitlin Clark and Angel Reese is the Magic Johnson and Larry Bird going into the WNBA and going to save the league. Both of them have come in breaking record, bringing massive interest into the league. And what better to have this great opportunity before them to become teammates and take down Goliath of this Olympic team? So, shout out to Caitlin. I can see her getting better. How hard the league, the own league being hard on and saying all type of things. But she done took it on the chin. You know, she had a privileged life, but now she done showed me something. She's more than just a, I can't say a pretty face. She's more than just a...
Why you can't say pretty face, man?
Because I'll be lying on Sunday. I don't need to lie on Sunday. I might try to lie tomorrow. But, yeah, I respect her work. She done put the work in, and you're seeing the results, the fruits of her labor. So I can't see. I'm waiting on next. I can't wait to see what's next for Caitlin Clark.
Choke on the cheese.
And Devil Reese. I mean, Angel Reese.
Here we go.
Okay, I'm glad. Angel Reese. LSU. Yeah.
You don't know what side you want to be on. You that dog, the LSU man I lied with.
That was well deserved. You don't steal from kids.
I thought Sam loved the kids.
I do. That's why I ain't like Jamarcus Russell stealing money from kids. Steal it from the Raiders like you've been doing.
You know what Bernie Mac said about them kids on that movie with Mike Epps?
Black Robin Hood. You can steal from the rich. Don't steal from the poor.
Anybody else today on the Caitlin Clark wave?
I'm gonna say this, and that's why I got this in the background. See, this is called marketing. You put Caitlin Clark on there, everybody's saying what's deserved. Sometimes it's not what's deserved, it's what's needed. And I go back to Isaiah Thomas on the Dream Team. Yeah, he was better than John Stockton inside, no matter how you look at it. But he wasn't what's best for the team because he was labeled a bad boy, a cancer, somebody who's gonna fight. You didn't wanna go overseas and start a fight with one of these people. Now you got a war going on. That's why they put Stockton, because it was better for the image. Same thing with Caitlin Clark. Stop the jealousy. Hey, we know what it is. Sometimes you look at the paint job and say no, and sometimes you just got to step back and say the game could have grown internationally, not just in America. You could have grown internationally by putting Caitlin Clark on there. So to me, sometimes you miss the boat always about what's deserved. Sometimes it's about what's best for business. As you can see, the WNBA voting has almost increased 5-6 times. I have never even watched a game since 1997. Now I'm watching it. So sometimes you got to take advantage. You got to strike while the iron is hot and get the money and let it play out. Shout out to Caitlin Clark and Angel Reese.
Yeah, I approve that mess.
Yeah.
Instead of taking John Stockton off that 92 team, take Chris Mullin off the team. I mean, John Stockton, the all-time leader in assists and steals in the NBA. So, say what you want to say about John Stockton was a gangster, man. Most of the Hall of Famers approved that. You know, Gary Payton and Magic and all of them.
What is that, Clutch? Because you let Joe get to talking about the 1800s. He'll go crazy.
So, when Clutch we talk about the five greatest in position, he go back to the 70s. He don't get no criticism, but I always get criticism. Carry on.
What's that, Clutch?
I say that, man.
No, that was me.
I mean, champ,
I want to say the producer can't get the names right.
I kind of want to see the All-Stars beat the Olympic team because the way they keep doing them rookies. And I kind of want to see Angel Reese get a double-double in the game. And I want to see Caitlin Clark hit for about 7 threes.
Yes, sir.
Get a triple-double. So I kind of want to see the All-Stars.
I'm intrigued. Buff.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I'm tuning in. Most definitely.
Well, I'm going to just say this. For Team WNBA, I would love to see at some point of the game DeJuana Bonner at center, Angel Reese at power forward, Arike Ogunbowale at small forward, Jonquel Jones at the two, Kayla Clark at the point guard. I would love to see that lineup.
Jonquel Jones, that's a woman's name?
Yeah. If you don't know, you will know a real song because that's about the only you'll know a real song.
Bet.
Y'all would love to see the girls win, the young girls. Y'all would love to see Kayla Clark double double. But y'all would love to see this fantasy basketball.
But I think Team USA gonna win.
I love to see $100,000 in my bank account that week, but that ain't. I mean. What are y'all talking about, man? Y'all talking about real stuff?
We're talking about the white man's paperwork.
I deleted that. Since we're going to history, Dream Team 1 had Christian Laettner, and he was a rookie. They still won by 44.
Never touched.
So that's why y'all want them to beat the Olympics in, because y'all great YT hype ain't on the team.
Well, I don't think I think Team USA is going to win, hands down. It's going to be a good, close game, but I think Team USA win by 8.
They do too, because ain't nobody came with the money on. Ain't nobody said nothing about putting no money on the All-Star game.
If I'm not mistaken, the 92 Dream Team actually lost to the college Dream Team or whatever they was. On TikTok video, Monster Mash was talking about it. And the media was outside, and they took the score off the scoreboard because they didn't want to see that they had got beat by the college superstars or whatnot.
You know why I want to see the All-Stars win? For a company, I'm talking about the business side, for a company that couldn't make money, couldn't produce this, and this is what they've been asking for day one. The pillars from the beginning, they've been asking for money. They've been asking for recognition, TV, to be exposed. And they took two people to help expose the league. And you all like, they hating on two people for exposing the league for something that you wanted. I want to see them get whooped for playing with these two young ladies. At the end of the day, it's almost, you know, you don't bite the hand that feeds you. Because if they didn't come into the league, you'd be still getting 95,000 All-Star votes. Nobody, they'll talk about you as an afterthought. We wouldn't be talking about no Dream Team. We wouldn't even be talking about them. Think about how many viewerships. This is not like LeBron coming into the league, but you already got Kobe and Shaq and Duncan and Garnett, Vince Carter, Paul Pierce, Tracy McGrady. You already had superstars and high ratings. LeBron just added to that. This is something where you don't have anybody in the league, and the league paid Michael Jordan $1 million, $1.5 million each to make sure Jordan stayed in there. This is that situation, except she wasn't Jordan yet. So just embrace it. You got it. Who cares? Stop all that hating and all that dry snitching. Talking about you the pillar, you the forefront, you behind. We don't care about that. Nobody cared about this league. I said it. Nigga, show the viewership.
Hey man, hush, man.
I said it.
Hush, quit hating, man.
Nobody. WNBA.
Listen, you're the kid. I'm the adult. Stop talking and wait till I'm done talking. Got it?
You hear me, Junior? Don't ever. Great take, Unpredictable Junior. Listen, I see you got your, I got the same little setup you got. Look at trying to be like a daddy. He trying to be like a daddy. The same little 2023-2024. So we had Asia Wilson, top five All-Stars in 2023. Asia Wilson, Breonna Stewart, Brittany Griner, Aaliyah Boston, and Jackie Young. So this year we got Caitlin Clark, Aaliyah Boston, Asia Wilson, Breonna Stewart, and Angel Reese. Angel Reese coming in five. So we had Jackie Young knocked out and Brittany Griner. I'm glad y'all got Brittany Griner back over here before y'all before she dropped out the top five. Cause with Caitlin Clark and Angel Reese, they might as well left Brittany Griner on over there. And is she crazy for getting? I wouldn't get on no plane to leave. I wouldn't leave the country no more.
Can't live your life in fear, home, bro.
You can live your life in jail over there.
Huh? They doing it to make extra money.
Just don't carry the weed around. You good. Simple fix.
I wouldn't carry a pack of cigarettes.
But Asia Wilson, exactly. Asia Wilson had 95,000. I'm gonna round up. She had 96,000 votes last year. This year she came in second with 618,000. Well, let's say 619,000. No, that was Aaliyah Boston. My bad. Aaliyah Boston had 72,000, and this year she got 619. She went over Asia Wilson, which is the best player in the NBA.
In your opinion.
In the masses' opinion, but.
Sometimes when you follow the masses, sometimes the M is silent.
Well, we know who. Speaking of the masses, we know. Hey.
Oh, you just called it. Just settle in.
Because I was working.
Settle in your spirits.
I was working. Speaking of the masses, the not best player in the NBA got 700,000, probably a career, historic vote.
Who's no. Jason Tatum?
No, Caitlin Clark.
Oh, you said NBA. You ain't said WNBA.
I said WNBA, man. Come on.
No, you didn't. Oh, yeah. Go back and run the tape.
Get a gray hair out your ears and you can hear me.
Well, how did you know?
I got one. On my birthday, one jumped out. But listen, are we going to watch this? Is this a thing?
Yeah, I'm watching.
Yes, I'm watching
too.
I'm
gonna watch it together.
Tune in.
A joke got a church picnic or something. You know he can't hang on the weekend.
Boy, I tell you,
you got a church picnic.
Lies ain't nothing for a nigga to tell. I mean, for a producer to tell.
That's on a Saturday, ain't it?
Yeah.
If you don't want me to come, just say you don't want me to come.
That's like I said. We go to the spot. We go to Spider Problem. And let them get the trip about their room on a Saturday. We'll see.
They be packed on the Saturday. I went up there on the Saturday. They be packed up there.
Don't they do?
Yeah. Man. I took my wife up there probably about a month ago.
Man, I'll be taking your wife to the spot, man.
Hey, man. Let them know I'm a real one.
He tried to get his own sponsorship. I go in there. They got some Trigger Man wings. I'm going off in them.
They go off then. I already passed the idea to them.
That's gonna be a big thing. That's gonna be huge. No,
probably gonna be the most watched NBA game of all time.
No doubt.
Box office.
Hey, you gotta go where the ratings at.
I think
you just look at her swagger, her movement, her shot. Man, she look like she done. That light bulb done came on. I'm impressed, man. I can't wait. I'm gonna stop being a hater.
She's rookie of the year, right? So before we get to Oregon, she's rookie of the year, right?
No, shoot. Angel Reese should be the front runner right now. Now, don't go too far.
I would probably say yeah, because I think they got a better overall team record. Seeing what they don't they steal?
I don't know no record. So rookie of
the
year.
What that did the Spurs win 10 games? What they got to do with rookie of the year, man?
That what they usually doing is a close race. Nobody was on Wimby level.
Should it be close?
Yeah.
Caitlin started off slow, but I think she scored more points and whatever amount of games they done played in the history of the game in the time span. So she cooking.
Didn't she just break a record of something with a triple double?
Five out of seven.
Yeah, she did.
Indiana has won one more game than Chicago.
Tell it.
Stop playing. Angel Reese for president.
I don't know.
Angel Reese got 8 wins. Caitlin Clark got 9.
This remind me. What
Angel Reese just dropped? 27 points, 18 rebounds. Man, stop playing with her.
She done broke the record for the double doubles to start a career or something.
Man,
she ain't lying.
Stop playing with Angel Reese like that.
Yeah, she tied. She just tied with 12.
No, okay. she done broke the record.
But she done broke some record, but I can't remember what it was.
She broke the double broke the double-double record at the free throw line with her mama in attendance. They lost the game, but her mama was in attendance for it.
But you forgot Caitlin Clark just had the first triple-double.
And she broke the double-double record.
All right, time out. It's six of us. Let's for half year, half summer, rookie of the year champ. Who you got?
I'm gonna go with Angel Reese.
DSPN, who you got?
Angel Reese.
Trigger Man Joe, who you got?
Angel Reese, but Caitlin Clark is coming.
Trigger Man Joe, who you got? Make your mind up. I said first half.
Oh, I said Angel Reese, man.
Okay, then you adding the other stuff.
I just told the choo-choo train. She
coming. We just add for the peanut butter. We ain't add for the jelly. Plus, who you got?
The Bayou Barbie, baby.
Unpredictable.
We already know who I'm going with. CC, Caitlin Clark, all day.
Steph Curry Jr.
So that's 5-1 on Angel Reese being the first half.
I am very proud of Unpredictable. He's really living up to his name. You would think, normally he's a homer. He's going to stick with LSU. He bashed Shakar Richardson across the head with that chair that the white man got hit down in the downtown at the water cross, whatever, the riverfront.
Yeah.
And he hit Shakar with that same chair.
Then the next week, he bashed Jamarcus Russell. He bashed Angel Reese.
I'm impressed. That takes kahunas to do that.
I bet everybody's an equal opportunity to get bashed unless they play for Bama. They go get it. If Caitlin Clark played for Bama in college, it would be Angel Reese.
Anyway, Joe gonna change. He gave himself the ability to change. Yeah, but Caitlin Clark coming. We'll had the discussion right before the voting.
His pick is fluid. It's fluid.
Thank you.
As Stephen A. say, it's fluid.
Indeed.
I'm gonna leave it alone because I don't want this to get long winded. The segment.
Yeah, we skipping on to let's see what we got here, but we're gonna check that out. Hopefully, we can check that game out together. Five, and we'll zoom time the other man.
You gotta bet that. How big is bet that 5-1 odds?
Bet 100, you get 500.
Off-season hard knocks with the New York Giants. Not gonna lie, really surprised by a lot of the stuff that I saw. We all know the biggest storyline of the offseason for the Giants was Saquon Barkley. But we didn't know how each person in the Giants organization felt about him. John Mara, the owner, really wanted him back. And Joe Shane, the Giants GM, was much more pragmatic and said, I don't know if it makes the most sense. But something very interesting about that whole situation, the entire Giants front office talked about this, but especially Joe Shane, the impact that last season with the drama, the holdouts had on the Giants kind of played a part in their decision. I'm going to go out on a limb and say it was part of the reason the Giants didn't trade him. But speaking of trades, we've all seen this clip with Brian Burns. Panthers GM Dan Morgan made it pretty clear at the Senior Bowl that the Giants could get Brian Burns if they wanted. He didn't know what it was going to be. But interestingly enough, Dan Morgan and Joe Shane have known each other for 20 years. Going to go out on a limb here too. I think that could have eased or aided the trade between these two teams. Because remember, the Panthers initially rejected two firsts for Brian Burns a little while back. Oh, Daniel Jones, man. Daniel Jones. Look, I love Daniel Jones, but when I'm about to say, we've been saying for the past 3 or 4 years, and the Giants agree with me in the Hard Knocks episode, they said this has to be the year. But this year is going to look very different because of no Saquon. Tim McDonald, Giants director of player personnel, was like, what do we do with our offensive identity if we lose like a ton of our production, a ton of our touchdowns? Joe Shane said, we're not paying our quarterback $40 million.
I appreciate you, my boy. I finished them cheeses. She got some meat in the sink, but she'll put it back in the freezer. So I had to go for what I know. I had to eat those cheeses. Miss Lady got some meat thawing in the sink, but she'll put it back in the freezer.
You're going to put your meat in the sink. I'm like, all right,
Children's I'm already thawed, baby. I already thawed out.
No diddy.
Pause.
So, Clint, he on mute and in disabled. Hey y'all watch this show?
You haven't seen clips of it.
Mm-hmm. Clutch was all into it, you know. I haven't watched it neither.
I ain't watched it, man.
Nobody watched it. Clutch wanted to talk about it, but he.
I saw it all for you.
You need to come on the production team. You got pictures and stuff everywhere. But you.
Why are you hating on him though?
I'm hating. I said I need some help.
We see the same thing you see. You got to reinforce what you see.
What?
Continue.
You know what? I was listening to Cam Newton talk, and he was talking about that little broken down quarterback that the Falcons got. And he said sometimes when a player can't play, we put him out there in the spotlight. But he said something that was like strong. He said for what they paid for the quarterback for Atlanta, I can't think of his name. He said you could have got Cam Newton, Michael Vick, and Chicago last starting quarterback for the same price that you're getting for him off of the Achilles. So he says sometimes nobody want to say it. The coaches, owners, and GMs don't know what the hell they doing. To me, you have an all-star, a future Hall of Fame type running back in Saquon Barkley, and you got this person who we've seen enough of that was hot garbage, but you quick to sign a quarterback because that's the trend. Sometimes you got to go against the trend. You could have gave Barkley $4-5 million more and got – you could have got Kirk Cousins for what Daniel Jones doing and came off better. Same thing what they did with Derrick Henry. No Bama intended. When they had Derrick Henry in the quarterback they signed. Quarterback had one good year with Derrick Henry. You give him 140. Meanwhile, you're giving Derrick Henry 10, say, prove it again. So sometimes, unless you have a quarterback that you know that's the future, that we can say he's a baller, he deserves it. Because we talked about Sunshine. He deserved more than we bought. We got to stop this quarterback pay trend just because they look nice. Pay the best player.
Hey, man, what is you talking about, man? You don't waste enough of my time. You don't waste enough of my time, bro.
You know who's wasting my time? You eating them Cheez-Its when I'm talking.
The difference is you wear your watch to tell time. I wore my watch to tell you how valuable my time is. There's a difference. Stop playing with me.
Come on, man.
You telling time. Man. I'm telling you my time is valuable. Don't waste it.
In other words, you're just like
talking about, man, what are you talking about?
You come out there with a hoochie purse?
You got on here. You got here talking about what Cam Newton talking about, man. Forget what Cam Newton talking about. Cam Newton wanted us to get him he could have been trying to sign with the Falcons.
No, he didn't say he want to. He said,
man, that man said that's the only place he'll sign because he ain't moving. Ain't nobody want Cam Newton.
So y'all wanted Kirk Cousins?
Ain't nobody want Cam Newton, man. Go on, give me that Falcon hat. Ain't nobody want Cam Newton. Y'all, because we drafted two quarterbacks. We got two quarterbacks. Then you just sit there and talk about we could have had four for that price.
No, he was
saying. What do you need four quarterbacks for?
Well, y'all need one because y'all ain't got none.
I mean, who your quarterback?
Better than y'all's.
We'll see.
I've heard the old expression.
Why y'all didn't get Cam Newton?
If you got two quarterbacks, that means you got none.
Y'all don't. Ever since y'all let Aaron go, y'all don't believe in black quarterbacks. So, but that's how you play your fantasy football too. So
We run too much. We want somebody sit in the pocket.
Yeah. Everything black in the city, but the quarterback.
That's all you need.
Anywho, anybody got something to say about the Giants?
Yeah, just take a lighter, gasoline, and just torch it.
All up.
Just torch the whole organization.
Clutch, you wanted to talk about this. What you got to say, man? You watch this show?
I was going away. What were we talking about?
We were talking about, you suggested we talk about the
Hard Knocks with Daniel Jones and Barker.
Do you watch the show? Have you seen the episode?
No.
Well,
no. I saw the clips like everybody else.
What you talking about? You want to talk about this? I guess you want to talk about this. They making moves and y'all didn't. The Cowboys did. What do you feel about The dude said, I don't even know these people. The dude, John Mara, not the John Mayer. I get mixed up with John Mayer, though.
That's the owner.
I sent you the clip.
That's the owner.
I ain't talking about no clip, man. You tell me what you want to talk about it. Talk about it.
Well, hold on, light skin. Who you yelling at?
I'm yelling at you.
Boy, hey, if you want to make it to the end of the episode, boy, you'll watch your tone.
No, he got a Gordon Contrell shirt on. Y'all know the Gordon Contrell?
I don't.
When one sleeve was longer than the other sleeve, had about four pockets.
On the Kyber show with Theo, had Vanessa make him a Gordon Contrell. Joe, you probably was.
I never really watched the Cosby Show. I'm not a fan.
Yeah, you probably doing grown man stuff back in the 80s.
That show was in the early 90s, too, wasn't it? It had to be.
Yeah, somebody,
when I was in boot camp, somebody said I looked like Bud. I ain't know who Bud was. I said, Bud, what does that mean? Some dude on the show. Real talk, real story. Well, I'm gonna give my take on it. X ain't gonna give his take.
Yeah, he don't know what he's talking about, man. DJ, worry about the Cowboys. We're gonna get on them. Let's go.
I kudos to the GM. He spoke his truth. I thank him for his honesty and transparency. We often criticize those who don't put a name and a face to the quotes, but this guy did that, and we want to criticize him. You know, this man got a job to do. You can't have it both ways. And you have to make tough decisions as leaders. And that's what he did. And
he ain't lie.
He didn't want to be burdened down and dealing with the stress of availability because both of these players,
he ain't lying.
They hurt. They stay hurt. So I'm going to get rid of one on while I have the opportunity to do so. But on that note, I really think Daniel Jones is going to have a big break back season.
You draft him.
I'm telling you, it's shocking.
A break back season. What?
Yeah, I got tongue twisted on that.
But, big back season. Yeah. That's what it's gonna be, a big back season.
Yeah. Well, lock the mark stay and lock that quote in, and when he go off, you know what we're gonna call it, a big back season or whatever I say.
Yeah.
Heard it here first. It improved the line. Daniel Jones got something to prove. And that's what it is.
He had a breath pop into the show.
He did put a name to it in the face. I respect that. But that's after he didn't give 4 years, $160 million with $92 million guaranteed. You're a little bit too little too late. Now, I can't say this in fairness to Daniel Jones. And one of his – he threw for 21 touchdowns and 17 interceptions and almost 5,000 yards, you know, prior to getting the contract. So I can't take that away, but those stats I gave you divided in half. That was for two full seasons. So in 25 games, that's what your stats, and you gave this man $160 million?
What a bad position.
Yeah, but I can see Sunshine because Sunshine is the franchise. Sometimes you overpay for the franchise player. Daniel Jones was never the fan. First of all, he played at Duke. You drafted a quarterback from a basketball school. That told me your IQ right there.
I agree with that.
Right.
But like Daniel Jones did on a Thursday night against the Philadelphia Eagles, was running at 22 miles per hour, somewhere around that.
And fumbled the ball, and they didn't even score a touchdown.
Cincinnati drafted a quarterback from a women's basketball school. That don't make them – baseball school. Y'all everything about a football school.
Ain't gonna let you talk about Joe Burrow now.
Hey, talking about the Heisman? The one who led his team to the Super Bowl? The one who led LSU to the championship? That's like comparing the legend of the Falcons to the legend of the Cowboys or the 49ers. That's not even in the same breath.
All right. We
that boy right now what he's in. That boy shows don't shoot in.
Good Lord. Hey, he shouldn't be apologizing for saying what Daniel Jones is. He should have fired himself for even starting that.
What move did come out, Joe? What move did come out?
Daniel Jones got a
should have. He ain't lying.
Daniel Jones should have got drafted at the same spot Bronny James got drafted.
Pretty much.
Dang.
All right, my man said, you're paying the guy. Jones, $40 million. is not to hand the ball off to a $12 million back, said GM Joe, white man name, during the season premiere of HBO Hard Knocks, which none of us has seen.
I'm going to go watch it. But the Steelers going to be all Hard Knocks.
When you a quarterback and you get that kind of money at that time, I strongly believe that you should be able to win no matter who's around you. I seen Patrick Mahomes win 2 championships and lost probably the most dangerous receiver ever. I've seen Tom Brady win championships, and I can't even tell you who his receivers was. I've seen just quarterbacks that elevate their play without talent. This man had talent, and he went backwards. And you signed him to a big-time contract?
What talent? What talent did he have, Sam?
First of all, you had Beckham at the time when he was still healthy. You had this running back.
He wasn't the quarterback then with Beckham.
Yeah, but you had a plethora of receivers and defenses, and you still only threw for 21 touchdowns and 17 interceptions in 2 seasons combined with 25 starts.
Man, all the
receivers. That man threw less than 1 touchdown a game.
All the receivers the Giants got. That's why we can't really name them. One of them from Auburn. Barkley was their best player. He stayed hurt, too.
Well, let's say this. Is his receivers that he's had, is it any better than Lamar Jackson receivers? For some reason, this man has won MVP twice. And that's the money you paying him? Like
Lamar Jackson got an all-world tight end.
All right, y'all. We're going to check out the show. We'll check out that show one day. Maybe they ain't watched the Clippers show like I asked.
Oh, I forgot all about
can
it.
We watch that? Yeah, I forgot all about it. These busy men got so
I'm
much.
I'm going to start watching that after I get off the show. I'm going to start watching it.
All right. Well, I doubt we watch Hard Knocks.
Danny Jones sounds like he should be a manager at Bass Pro Shop.
Quarterback picked up a minor foot sprain. I don't think that this is going to affect his fantasy value at all. However, it is something to keep an eye on because if this boot lingers into August, if there's heavy tape jobs, visible limps, if the word Liz Frank starts getting thrown around, then I would consider not drafting him at all because he's going to have serious limitations to his mobility. Now, that being said, the team is saying that this is minor. It should not be an issue. On a personal level, it does suck for Dak because going into his contract year last year, well, he ended up having that leg fracture after having an awesome majority of his season. Now he's kind of dealing with some foot injuries. So hopefully this is nothing. Hopefully he can rock because I am targeting him in a lot of fantasy leagues. I think him and CD are going to absolutely explode this year. So.
Are you telling too much? Telling too much business.
Domino.
Dallas Cowboy expert, Clutch. Is this a big deal that your quarterback was in a walking boot going deep sea fishing, diving, things of that nature?
I mean, if it were that serious, he wouldn't be walking on it at all. So I don't think it's anything serious. And he should be okay, for camp. And whatever that guy just said, they're going to have him and CD going to have a great year here. They had a great year last year. It's going to be better this year. Don't be down. Don't be downplaying my Cowboys.
Who?
All y'all.
Y'all do a good job of that by y'all selves. Y'all don't need no help.
You know what? Clutch, I'm finna back you up just a little bit. I'm finna back you up.
Oh,
it's big news because number one, Dak Prescott is the most important person on his team right now. He's more important than Michael Parr. He's more important than Jerry Jones. He's more important than all of them right now. I'll put it like this. In 2022, Dak threw for 2,860 yards. That's when he had Pollard and Zeke, right? Didn't he have both of them?
More than likely, yeah.
Yeah, both of them that year.
Yeah.
Last year, he lose Zeke, so they lean on Pollard more. They think Pollard is the bell cow. He throw for 4,500 yards. This year, you get Zeke back, you lose Pollard. You have no run game at all besides the goal line. That might throw for 6,000 yards this year if he helped him.
Oh, what?
Is that going
to – I ain't saying that's going to win them a Super Bowl. I ain't saying that's going to win them the playoffs. I ain't saying that brings anything. But if we're
we don't have a running back. You said we don't have any running backs? Is that what you say?
Who y'all
is that what
back?
You said?
Who y'all running back?
He said Zeke going to run for 1,200 to 1,500.
We got Roy Freeman.
What?
We got Roy Freeman. We got Roy Freeman backing him up. Burgers? We got Rico Dowdle backing him up. What are you talking about?
Who are these people?
So with all these running backs, Zeke still going to run for 1,200?
Whoa,
you ain't never heard of Roy Freeman?
No,
he
already got
that money coming.
He didn't run the ball with the Rams. What Clutch not finna do is talk about all these people that done got cut by four teams and make them think they relevant. Royce Freeman.
Wait a minute. Wait a
Ezekiel
minute.
Elliott. You know them two running backs just came like from the
just
most.
Say what you just said.
Exactly. You telling me they just came from these highly run heavy offenses and they finna come over here and do something? Man, please listen. Dak for $6,000.
Put your money where your mouth is. They gonna combine for 1,200 yards rushing altogether.
Put your money where
your mouth is. Double E. We want
put your money where your mouth is.
This is my bet. I guarantee you Dak throw for 5 times y'all lean rushing.
Gotta do your math on that. I don't know.
You and White King, y'all little young, cats be saying some stupid shit. Why would I do that? Why in the hell would I do that?
That's a good bet.
A good bet to me is
that man said 5 times. It's the same thing you just said. You say the man going to run for 1,200.
You say he going to run for 1,200. That means that got to throw for 6,000.
Never been did before.
I said you're a leading rusher. Pick one.
He don't know who they're going to be.
No.
I already got that bet locked in.
So we're going to lock it on 1,200? I don't need no help from Dak.
Y'all leading rusher going to have...
He'll rush for more than Derrick Henry. How about that?
How much you want to put on that?
You want to put something on that? We'll talk after the show on that
one. All right. Y'all lead.
I want to get in your pockets deep. I'm putting this on record.
Y'all leading rusher will have.
Now you're chasing clout, and that's what we're not going to do here. Okay.
Leading rusher won't have more than 700 yards.
Derrick Henry won't make it past the sixth game.
Can I spend this time?
And he'll have more yards than y'all. Still.
Hold on, what my son want to say?
Can I say this about what we're talking about? Hey, and it's called follow the money train. All right? So I'm going to give y'all a quick history lesson from the last 2-3 years, not 30 years ago.
Make sure it's quick.
Joe Burrow, get hurt. Highest paid quarterback in the league. Sunshine, get hurt. Highest paid quarterback in the league.
Garbage.
Justin Herbert, get hurt. One of the highest paid quarterbacks in the league.
Garbage.
Hurt. Highest paid.
These MVP.
See, what they do is this. They don't want to pay them up front, but then they get hurt. And now the team starts to understand their value. So Dak is saying, hey, you don't want to pay me? You're going to learn my value today. All right. You're going to learn today. This is strictly business. That man didn't hurt himself. He got one of the biggest contracts coming off, ripping his leg off. That's what they understood, Cousins. The money is, if you don't value me when I play, you're going to sit there and watch when I'm not playing in the season. Now, the fans, everybody in the organization, they're going to put pressure on you to sign me because they know we got hot garbage behind us. Just follow the money.
If I'm that,
I actually like Dak, Dakota, from Louisiana, the boot. I actually like him. But here's the thing. Every time his contract came up, he got – let me come on camera on this one. Every time his contract came up, he got hurt. Mm-hmm. Follow the money. See, if he's gone and a man don't play back well, they go find somebody else. But if he's still on that team, the team's going to look at when the hell you going to pay Dak. As long as you got another quarterback right there, they know capable, you got issues. So let Dak sit right there because next time it's going to be my knee. Next time it's going to be my neck. Hey, I'm going to be like here, my neck and my back. I'm going to do all because I'm getting paid. Follow the money. That's all. Ronnie ain't good. He just sold a bunch of jerseys. That's just for money. That's all
this
is about. Get your money, Dak. Show them who you are.
I agree.
Dak top 3-4 in the league.
I agree.
And, I'm piggyback right quick off what Sim said. I think it's brilliant marketing by Dak. There's nothing wrong with Dak. Very minor. And if the Cowboys decide letting him play out the last year on his contract, and like DSPN said, the man get ready to throw for $6,000, he probably won't reach that. But he's gonna put on a classic season, and he's gonna be worth more money than he will be this year if you don't pay him. So, if he didn't want this to get out, he wouldn't be out there in the public's eye with a serious injury. But this is what the Cowboys do; they need some attention in the off seasons or whatnot. And
Dak top three, pay the man. Dak top three, pay the man.
Yeah.
I'm waving at a ghost. Casper came and visited me.
Oh, you all right?
I hear dead people.
I was sitting. Oh, it's slizzling. Sound like Shannon. Yeah. Shout out to Uncle Shay. Appreciate it. Everybody had a great input. I wish Uncle did my show up quicker with here. At first, instead of, you know, say, hey, I got one more. But that was great. And I think it's only a story because it's the Dallas Cowboys. Certain stuff only a story because it's the LA Lakers or the New York Yankees or whatever you have there.
When's that time the Cowboys been to the Super Bowl?
Oh, here we go with that shit again.
I'm just asking.
Nick, stop.
I'm asking. I forget sometimes. I'm 53 years old.
You ain't forgot. You just
when they went to the NFC Championship.
You just trolling.
I'm going to help them out. NFC Championship, that should be a little closer.
When that dude fumbled that ball on the goal line. Look at that.
Man, the Cowboys got a better chance.
Was that the championship? That won the championship game, wasn't it?
David is dead.
Get rid of Jerry Jones and bring in
Daniel
Jones.
I think that was like.
All right, we got 100 more miles to go. Let me, Joe. This guy want to talk to you.
Josh is going to run up the league this year.
I appreciate it. Yeah.
Araw ay ating summarize muli ang naging takbo at lagay ng mga free agents ngayon sa kasalukuyang nagaganap na off season ng NBA. Nasa na nga ba ang ilan sa mga naglalakiang pangalan sa mundo ng basketball? By the way, this is Quiz Ryan ng La La Land PH, where we talk about basketball and sports updates. Kaya naman, i-like, i-share, at mag-subscribe o follow ka na, Lods, sa channel natin para lagi kang updated sa mundo ng basketball at sports. Center Luke Kornet has agreed on a one-year deal to return to Boston Celtics. Free agent...
Joe, what is...
Cat going international.
Boy, I got triggered then, boy. I'm just
hey.
I'm glad you took it out. I wouldn't have been able to handle the whole video. Dang.
Who was that, Dim Sum?
Them some you win and them some you lose. Man, what's
I
going
see
on
that video.
Man, they
man,
own all the hotels,
video.
They own the gas stations. Your credit card call you that you can't get nobody to speak English. Let me stop.
Man, I seen that video. I said, oh, I got to put this up here because Joe gonna go off.
Man, that's crazy. Yeah. Boy, that's so crazy right there. Oh man, so I don't even know how to find it.
He would take.
I don't. Dang. I mean, how many views he got?
He would talk about the trades and free agency.
That man said nothing about no trade. That man said something about I must have blanked out.
DSPN, we're gonna talk about the trades and the extensions and all of that the free agency that's taking place this past week. You got any to stand out to you?
I think the biggest two big takes that might not be so big. The Knicks losing Hartenstein is actually a bigger take than a lot of people will say, because he was their only healthy big last year that could withstand the toll of the season. And also, DeMar DeRozan going to Sacramento is – they wanted Brandon Ingram. Brandon Ingram did not make the cut or getting traded. So they got DeMar DeRozan, and I think that pairing him with De'Aaron Fox and Sabonis, that's a really good look. And you got Keegan Murray and the rest of those young guys. You get a veteran there to help them get them over the hump. So I like Sacramento moves.
All right. Trigger Man Joe, you wanted this to be a topic. So what you got, buddy? Pal?
I like the DeMar DeRozan trade as well. I think he's like 35 now, but he still can get you 20 to 25 points a night. He ain't gonna give you no defense, though. His defense is gone. But they re-signed Malik Monk. So, and Keegan Murray, he's coming around. He's probably in his third or fourth season. And they already was one probably top five scoring offense already. So you interject someone like DeMar DeRozan into the lineup, it can't help but to get better. But the defense is still going to be a problem for the team. But OKC to me is to be the number one seed in the West and to lose to Dallas. And they added the black man, Harrestein, or how you pronounce his name. But they also got Alex Caruso in a trade. And LeBron never wanted him to leave L.A. because he's a good ball handler, excellent defensive guy, can shoot the three at a pretty good clip. But the thing that stands out the most to me, and it just breaks my heart, is that Klay Thompson didn't get to stay with the Golden State Warriors. Before he came to the Warriors, him and Steph, the Splash Brothers, they were trash. Once again, let me repeat that. They were trash. So this man is supposed to be a Bay Area legend. How do you get rid of a legend, but you keep Draymond Green, who probably the all-time leader in technical fouls, and you give him $100 million, and this dude Klay like this? And Klay light-skinned. Normally light-skinned people don't even get dealt like this, but I love the way he told Steph Curry, hey, don't speak up for me, don't say nothing. They already showing how much they care about me. I'm out of here. And kudos him to him not coming to the Lakers because LeBron, he make lesser players better, but better players become lesser when they come to playing with LeBron. So kudos to Klay and much success. And that's all I have to say about that. You don't know nothing about that.
Clutch, you got a take on this?
They pretty much said it all.
You upset about them Cowboys. Lady rocking back and forth. He's still thinking about that Cowboys. Who
are
that lady in the green?
And oh man, breaking news. It had been discovered that LeBron James is sleeping with his newest teammate's mom. This is facts.
It's facts.
It's facts, man. They finally got LeBron.
Who his teammate?
His son,
LeBron James.
His son.
Oh.
Why you hey light skin, don't do my boy like that. Don't do him like that, man.
But y'all talking about some real stuff, man.
That was it's real.
That ain't no real, man. Get out of here, man.
He's sleeping with his teammate mama.
That's real.
Well, if he ain't slept with her in years, they sleep in a separate bedroom. They just stay together to for the cameras and stuff. And he go sleep with all the other people out there in the streets and she do her thing.
Hey, Gil's Arena, he already said, "Hey, Bronny, it's gonna be a love and basketball episode." You remember when the dad went there told his son how the road is, how the women throwing themselves at it?
Oh.
Hey, you can't go back and tell mom everything.
Oh.
He going to the G League. He ain't gonna be that long.
Yeah, he ain't gonna
play one of the first, probably the first couple of weeks of the season. Gonna play him and LeBron gonna match up playing a game and then he going out to the G League.
How long LeBron been playing in the league?
20 years.
How many games have what's the wife's name? Sabrina? Savannah? How many games she been to, you think?
She been to a lot of
them. She ain't been to no lot of games.
But she hasn't.
She ain't been to no lot of games.
Man, they're the most famous NBA wife out.
That don't make it. I mean, make her being at the game.
That means she all the way around the club.
Okay, well, her son on the team now. And Norman, moms go all out for their babies, for their sons. How many games she going to be at now?
True.
With this new dude in town. Well, he ain't got to be on the team to be at the
game. Brian, think about that part.
What you mean?
Hey, it ain't no more groupie sneaking in.
He didn't
bought sand to the beach.
I told you you got to worry about no more for about two weeks. They're going to send him out to the G League.
Allegedly on LeBron, man.
Oh,
shit. Y'all niggas
sound like hey, but one thing about it, I never tear down our fellow black men. I do not like LeBron James as an athlete and all the other stuff, but I ain't going to tear down his marriage. That man don't cheat.
Right.
Everybody.
Yeah, I'm like you, DSP, and I ain't gonna tear another black man down. You know. Just like I think Nelson Agholor and Deontay Hardy gonna have 1,000 yards receiving this year for y'all.
Nelson Aguilar. Who you play for?
The Ravens.
Oh.
Not alligator arms.
Who right. Y'all? Who y'all but, wide receiver?
You don't know.
Hey, Ellen Boy.
Hey, hope. Hey, I don't need to save it one. Agency. I don't need to save it one, and that's CeeDee Lamb. That's all I need to say right
now.
Last year, y'all had hopes that a 5'4" running back was going to run away with the job.
Oh. Hey, we're about to get into football season. All right, y'all chill.
That's why Josh Johnson.
Well, you know his dad, on the staff. They just did him a solid to get the old boy on the team.
And that's what I'm talking about. They running back group. They ain't getting over 700. Trash.
All right, we're gonna get to football. Trash. Listen, we talking about basketball right now.
Ellen Boy, back to free agency. Mm-hmm. I think the outside of Paul George, because I think because of his name, that was a great move to get out the West and go to the East, where he only got to face Boston instead of everybody else. I'm gonna say this because they sorry ass is always on television. The biggest move is not even Klay, because I saw Klay last time in the Golden State uniform.
Don't tell me you're finna say Pelicans.
I'm not even gonna say that. The biggest move is the Lakers didn't get anybody but his son. That's the biggest move. There's no move to be made. You're the Los Angeles Lakers. You're the biggest brand in North America, possibly. You got the biggest superstar possibly ever. And in free agency, you got zero. They passed up you to go to Dallas. They went to Sacramento. They went to the city of brotherly love. That's something that's going on in L.A. For you to be the Lakers, the brand, and you just saw your all-time rival Boston win a championship, and the only thing you gave me was that J.J. Redick, somebody I'll play one-on-one and whoop his ass, and then his son.
Stupid ass.
Both of them today. That's your biggest move?
Listen.
No, you ain't with nothing. All right. He went to Dallas. A team that went to the NBA Finals. Mm-hmm. You went to Dallas, somebody that don't have a state tax.
Mm-hmm.
You know how much it costs to stay in Dallas to compare to LA?
Hold on. What you're not finna do is make this a political thing about money. What you're not gonna do is Klay chose to go with the most ball-dominant player in the league, even more than LeBron. The most. LeBron, let y'all tell him, LeBron passed the ball the most. Why wouldn't I want to go to L.A.? Besides not wanting to play with LeBron.
That's correct.
Well, Klay said Dallas is a more NBA title team ready. He said the Lakers ain't.
They need
a lot more than just him.
They
That's
what he said.
Well, see, here's the thing about Klay that I'm saying. I'm not just saying Klay, because when Paul George went to Philadelphia, they got state taxes. When the guy who just went to Sacramento, state taxes in California. I'm just saying, why is everybody bypassing L.A.? It's a reason.
Because don't nobody want to go to a clown show.
They don't
want
to play with LeBron, man.
We want to see a clown. We go to the circus, not the NBA.
And not only that, people don't appreciate what they did to Westbrook, man. That was garbage how he did it.
Yeah, to him.
Yes.
I ain't got time, man.
What about you,
a Laker fan? You ain't no Laker fan.
Listen, what y'all are never, ever going to do is bash Westbrook. Every player that has ever played with Westbrook has either
never had that bad thing about that.
Every player that has ever played with Westbrook and that was a star has either won MVP or played their very best. They had their very best season. They either had their very best season or they won the MVP. It's never been in between.
What you got to say about that producer?
I don't know what this nigga
you got to worry about producer with the shades on. All the video. All on the radio.
KD, MVP. Harden, MVP.
The two biggest franchises in the NBA are the Celtics and the Lakers.
Now, Harden had MVP last year. What are you talking about? Quit coming on the end of the subject, and then
the Celtics,
go ahead.
Just win a championship. So they re-signed their players. The Lakers lost in the first round, and you got the same team except for J.J. Redick and your son. That is awful for a franchise that has the prestige of the Lakers. I expect the Pelicans to do stuff like that. I expect the Hawks, some bottom feeders. I expect more from L.A. You don't get nobody.
They couldn't even get Chris Paul. They can't get Chris Paul.
In his prime, too.
Well, I think the Boston Celtics had the best offseason draft trade by resigning everybody.
Okay, now you're chasing clout. That's what we're not going to do here, okay?
And I can't lie to you, because Boston didn't let not a soul walk up out of there.
Off a championship team. The Lakers did the same thing.
And traded
who
everybody.
Who your team here, man? I'm talking about the Lakers. Who you like?
I'm Miami Heat. Okay. We know what the Heat about. And we ain't about that foolishness.
Perms and micro braids and stuff. Yeah, hey, that was all.
Guess what? You know one thing about the Heat when you a champion?
Jimmy.
See,
Fix Jimmy.
We don't have to have the very best to be there. We've been in the championship. Now, have we won it? No. But the team we had, our team would know better than the Lakers, but we got further than them.
You're a Pelican fan now.
I haven't lived in New Orleans when they've been there, but I think I can't convert yet.
Okay, but look, despite y'all opinions, we got the what is gambling stuff called? DSM,
LeBron
championship 24-25 winner plus 300 after all these trades been made. The Boston Celtics. Anybody know who's at 2 at plus 850?
Philadelphia.
What?
Philadelphia 76ers, the winner championship. At 850 with the 76ers, you have who?
Paul George. Embiid.
No. Yeah, he with the 76ers. I'm saying, what team up next in the rankings to win the championship?
OKC.
Don't be Googling. OKC.
I'll say Denver. I ain't Googling. They had the 2 strong pieces. They were the number 1 seed in the West.
What people trying looking at? It's all in no menu.
And then I would probably have to fall out no order. I haven't looked at any. I would think Minnesota, Dallas, and Denver would fall out the rest of it.
Next, we got Denver at 900.
Wow.
Ain't nobody mentioning the team my name about 2 weeks ago when I have y'all with him.
What we got going on here?
The New York. The New York Knickerbockers.
Oh, Knickerbockers. Boy, you wild. Boy, you wild.
You
didn't
go to Sunday school anymore.
I like them prior to Paul George signing.
I went to regular church.
Like I said, them losing.
You got the Timberwolves at 950. You got the Timberwolves at 950. So you got the Celtics, Sixers, Thunder, Nuggets, Knicks, and Timberwolves.
But the East has gotten tougher with the acquisitions. And if John Randle come back healthy, and then Paul George, but you know, it's almost a given that Embiid gonna be hurt at some time. I hope he don't, but history shows that if you forget history, it shall repeat itself.
Yo, what's going on with Clutch? No, that ain't the first pitch.
He said something about the Cowboys. He going to
that. No, he had something else. Y'all watch. Hey, rewind about 10 seconds and see what Clutch. Let's just let a personal.
Some butt naked on that. Boston going to the finals the next 3 years in a row, man.
Hey, next. Now, I gave you a little clap. You went too far.
Next 3.
I don't see nobody stopping them.
New York, Villanova is tying
each other for a spot in the Olympics.
We need a chicken dinner.
That was worth the wait.
All right. Here's everything you need to know. The Basketball Olympic qualifiers are happening right now, where 24 teams are fighting for the remaining 4 spots in the Olympic Games. Everything led to a semifinals match between Slovenia's and Greece's national teams and their superstars, Luka and Giannis. After a big defeat against Croatia, Slovenia managed to beat New Zealand by 26 points and secured the second place in their group. Doncic recorded.
All right, so, yesterday we had Luka and Giannis face off against each other.
Give a little break.
Hold on,
news.
Let me let you host. Hold on. Yeah.
My bad. Oh, sorry, sir. Go ahead, sir. I apologize.
Why you got the mic in front of your face?
So he can host. Listen.
In your feelings, huh?
Joe, who won yesterday between Greek Freak and Luka? Since you want to talk.
Greek Freak.
I didn't even know they were playing, but if I had to put money on it, it'd be Luka.
No.
That man just gave you the answer and you still
it wasn't
Luka be home for the summer. He's not going to the Olympics.
It wasn't even close.
He ain't gonna be in America neither, but it, yeah, the blowout. A DSBN be everywhere but here.
I actually got a text across my phone that Giannis crying about making the team. So I knew, so I like to be controversial at times.
Yeah, and then Giannis only had.
What they meant? Hey, yo, what are you doing? Man?
What you doing your free time?
Hey, Clutch, yo. It's a fantasy.
And just to say this, it only took Giannis to score 13 points for them to dog walk Luka yesterday. He only scored 13.
That's impressive.
What you talking about? The picture of Luka?
What Radio said on the movie? I like both. I like both
Both. Oh.
But did Giannis' brother play?
No. He's not on the team.
Wow. How did he not make the team, man? That man made the NBA. But Sam, Upper Dipper don't never have nothing to say about that.
You got to have my brother, too. You know what I'm saying?
That's how he got in the league.
Yeah, you're right.
No, actually, you know, I just watched how did Giannis' brother get in the league, and it was actually an impressive story. The first year that Giannis came out, they wanted the Nassis then because he was Giannis' brother. So, because he wasn't into the draft, he had to go and play in the G League. And the Nassis was the first player ever drafted out the G League. And he actually played well in the G League. But he was the first player. He was the first player actually drafted out the G League.
But a couple of years ago, they had a chance to cut him or whatever.
Now why he's still in the league is because of Giannis' brother. But he actually...
Yeah, I heard
it. He actually performed well enough to be drafted. He scored more than 4 points. I know that, but
man, I believe everything you hear, man. I seen
that boy movie. Crazy right there, boy.
I seen that movie, man. I don't believe everything
that
you hear.
That boy is crazy. That boy needs some medication.
So let's see since Clutch think USA not gonna win gold, he got a couple wages out against that. I don't know if you hear DSPN to hear that. Clutch said, we lucky if we win America. If America go bronze, we lucky then to get a bronze. So it was some wages said I want him to silver to be the
go ahead and say that stupid shit push. You said last week.
I said, following Joe when Joe took the gold bet.
I took a gold bet?
Yeah. You remember that?
I took one.
I don't know. Did you?
Yeah, I got a real idea.
How much I think, Champ,
normally write it down.
I got one
for 50.
I got one for 50. Me and Champ, because I wanted silver to be the push. But he said, they got to win gold.
But I ain't get no thumbs up or thumbs down.
I don't think me and Joe locked anything in.
Okay.
Oh. I know Champ and
just so I'm hearing it correct.
Light skin.
Champ. Light skin and Champ got USA winning gold.
Yeah.
And X-Man, you got them barely getting bronze.
Yeah, yep. I said we'll be lucky to get bronze.
But he wouldn't take the silver now. I said silver. Now, if silver, nobody win.
Hey,
but no, Joe jumped on here and they didn't even bet.
I tried. What
are
you talking about? I tried.
But I'm saying you want to change it.
Breaking news. We don't care.
Man, don't try to take out my clips.
I'm here to tell you right now.
I play them for you. You won't.
We don't care.
You, Stephen Gates Smith?
Stephen Gates Smith?
Yeah. You look like. I ain't even going to say it. I ain't going to do you like that.
Please don't.
Let's not get too long.
Stevie Dumpling.
We got three more topics.
I report you on the airplane when you get here. Listen. So since Clutch think that you're in the United States ain't gonna win gold, who y'all got winning gold?
Man, come on, USA, man.
Clutch, clutch. Who you got winning gold since you think at the USA?
Let me see.
Spain.
Yeah.
You went Spain the wrong way. Went the wrong way, cuz.
He went the wrong way when he dressed up this morning. Spain. NBA players Santi Aldama.
Ricky Rubio.
Lorenzo Brown, former Rudy Fernandez, former.
He used to be pretty good.
Usman Garabu from the Thunder. Juancho Hernangómez, former Willie Gomez, former. You really don't have no NBA teams on your Spain. Who you got, DSPN?
NBA teams on your Spain.
On his Spain team.
NBA players, not NBA team.
I mean, it'll probably be Greece versus USA.
Are you serious?
I said Greece versus USA.
Greece might struggle to get in today. Then they got to win today to get in.
They already won and got in.
You know, just told you breaking news, and you don't pay attention. I gave you the answer.
What answer you gave me?
Get it, Trigger Man. Get it.
Yeah, but Greece has you got the Giannis and Kostas. That's the other brother. Antetokounmpo, Nick Klathes, Georgios Paganos, and Kostas Papagiannopoulos. What's that, Joe? You said something? Oh, we can't hear you. Okay. We'll let get him, Joe. Be quiet for a minute.
I'm going
with
Canada.
Get it, boy.
Canada. When has Canada ever won anything?
They got the ball.
I'm saying the United States gonna win the gold, but Canada should be there.
Canada.
Why you think that?
Because they got K-Dot beat Drake gets the get back.
Three or four good NBA players on that roster.
They got Nickeil Alexander Walker, RJ Barrett,
and SGA.
King Bird. Okay. I just wrote this down instead, for no reason. For you to just yell out players. You think I went in the SGA?
Oh, I'm apologize.
Jamal Murray ain't on there?
But Fundo, Kubanglia, Trey Lyles, Jamal Murray, and Andrew King, Nembhard, Kelly
Olynyk.
Yeah, thank you.
And the Golden State Warriors blocked Andre Wiggins from going on now.
Why?
I don't know, man. They
want to
get hurt.
That's a good squad, though. That's a good squad. So you, what if the whole show get blocked because the man got music playing? What if you? We in there now, really? We in there now? But
we do not own the copyrights to these songs. I repeat,
Facebook, not you.
We don't own the copyrights to these songs.
Grandpa,
hey, I just don't believe in the USA.
Oh, here he go, last
the talent. Not because of Ellen Boy looked like Doughboy from Boys in the Hood. It has nothing to do with that. I just think that the people we got, they too old and they low managed. And I just don't see them playing that many games at one time. Over the last 10 years, they haven't proved they could do it for real. So if you're getting paid millions to do it and you can't play more than two games in a row, I can't see you do it for pride. That's just me.
All right, so we'll stay tuned in a couple weeks when that Olympics come around. Now we got to talk about this amazing effort over the 4th of July.
The kid, are we open? Badlands in a zone here. I don't know it's like a wave machine. Ladies and gentlemen, Badlands Booker, a new world record.
Hero.
And for anybody that wasn't on the call Thursday, Gino said that he can do it in less than a minute.
No deal. No.
Hey, he used to finish his stuff in a minute. He should you be used to that.
I got money on it.
He said he gonna go lunch for he gonna go dinner bill for dinner bill.
No, I did not. Because that was stupid. That was stupid once I realized it. That was stupid once I realized. Somebody said I got money. I don't a gallon. That looked like a light gallon. Shout out to Badlands that's, Booker.
That's just a big guy.
So he made the gallon look smaller. I don't know. Anybody think they could do that? Do something in that nature?
Nah.
No.
In a minute? We ain't even talk about 21 seconds in a minute.
In a minute, nah. Drink a gallon of water.
Nah.
What about a Sprite? A whole 20-ounce Sprite?
No, nah, definitely.
That ain't nothing.
In 20 seconds.
Yeah, I can do one in probably 21 seconds.
No, you can't do that. That Sprite gonna be coming off. Listen, man, I got videos in my phone.
McDonald's Sprite.
I got videos. You're breathing hard. Trying to get people to drink a Sprite in one breath. You can't take a breath. You can't stop. Got to keep going. You can't do it, cuz.
I'm not gonna do that, if
it's 21 seconds, it's 21 seconds.
Man, you gonna have a Sprite coming out your eyes.
Hey, money talk. Tell them folks, the Joe got a sponsor. We coming down there. We gonna do some. I can knock out a Sprite. Oh man, Sprite different. Man.
I can't believe we're discussing this topic. We have stooped to an all-time low.
It's to make this,
it's a sport.
Man, to make this a
topic, we in
man.
The off-season.
We gonna talk about the hot dog. I know you'll be tuned show. In. I know you.
Congratulations in order to Bootleg Booker, whatever name.
Hey, Carl, I'm out here drunk as a Sprite. Let us pray.
That's my graveyard and women of what you call the casket. That's how I want to look right there. So I got an early preview look of what I'll be looking in the cast.
Man, you're gonna look better than that, cuz we're gonna make sure of it.
Cool. Appreciate that. Appreciate good looking out.
I'm trying to see what actor he looked like. Oh,
hey, man. I just want to say
that's that raw dog Charles right there.
What a name, bro.
That's our raw dog Charles when he cleared that thing and done.
good 13 pumps and I'm done.
I'm in a bind, Nate.
Oh, man.
Look at the pitcher boy right here. He good with the pitcher. Yo, your boy looked the crazy drinking that gender. Oh, yeah, it looked like a gallon when Carrot Top hands on the right.
Yeah. They can't even lift it.
it do like a gallon. I can't. I could do that in a minute. No diddy. I could do some water.
No, you can't, cool.
A gallon of water in a minute.
I'm telling you.
Yeah, I'm doing no gallon, cool.
Man, you're not doing a gallon nothing in a minute. Them people trained to do that. And you think you finna do it?
And that stuff is not healthy to your organs doing
water ain't.
Like, body ain't designed to be doing
no
that
water.
Stuff.
You flush your organs out because I want you to try. I would love I'm gonna root for you to do it.
I'm gonna sound like a 20-ounce, like a 20-ounce.
You just go from a gallon to a 20-ounce.
You can do a 20-ounce in a minute. I want you to do the gallon. You're talking about.
How you backpedaling from a gallon?
I can drink a bottle of water. I can drink a bottle of water in 10 seconds. I can drink a bottle of water in 10 seconds.
You can do a bottle of water. You ain't gonna do a Sprite in 10 seconds, I bet.
Not in 10.
You ain't gonna do it. You ain't gonna do it in 20.
I have one way to figure that out. That when we have our draft pod, we just bring some 20-ounce Sprite balls.
No, y'all niggas ain't have me messed up, and I got this draft some more.
I'm telling y'all right now, anybody that drink a Sprite in 20 seconds, a 20-ounce bottle of Sprite in 20 seconds, I got $20 for every one you finish.
Ain't no way.
Get ready.
I'm trying.
You gotta make it more enticing.
Don't have caffeine in it, but it got the bubbles.
It's free. It's a free 20. You don't lose anything for trying.
Get ready.
I said, dude, do it on TikTok. No, he had 40 seconds.
Don't worry about it.
I can't believe he finished. I don't believe Chump.
Don't worry about it, Chump. Gonna be pissing all the way to the championship.
what we got left? Cause we finna get up out of here. What we got left? Oh, okay. Let's check this out.
Got them a pinky toe.
Let's check this out right here. What we got?
That happened over there. Let me tell you something. When the first dude stepped up to Rose, the little short fat one that looked like Bam Bam Bigelow from wrestling, when he stepped up, and then I squat down in his eyes and told him what I said. Basically, boy, if I hit you, I'ma see everything you ate for the last 2 days. His balls dropped out of his ass. He never said another word. He never did nothing. He was a straight buster. Then the behind him said, I know MMA. And then I got hit with a drink. I'm still convinced ain't on the punch me. Somebody said, Rose, the nigga tried to punch you. He hit you. I say, nah. He had to throw a drink, because throwing a drink would have been way more disrespectful than screaming, I know MMA. Man.
Kiss the camera. Y'all know what them folks in Vancouver told him? Hold on.
I'll swing over that way. You got an iron through your clothes. I'll swing that way and kick some ass. I don't have time for this. I won't take no disrespect.
Yeah, they put the pause on that count. Even though Rick Ross only got hit once, they got all up out of count.
Anybody seen the video? Let you see the video of Rick Ross and his squad? That was
I saw it. And yeah, I also saw, you know, right afterwards, Rick Ross in his limousine or whatever, his car, drinking some champagne or whatnot. But did you see the clip I sent you with Uncle Luke telling Mr. Drake and Mr. Ross that they need to cut this out because he's seen it before with Biggie and Pop?
Man, don't nobody, we ain't stopping none. That's why it's soft now. Don't stop nothing.
He said he's seen how this is going to end. He said, yeah, when you keep it on wax and you're talking, Pop, that's one Biggie thing. But when you start, you know, putting hands on people, it's another.
So that's why it's soft now is crazy.
Drake ain't finna touch.
You no freaky ass nigga.
Drake ain't going nowhere past Vegas. He ain't even going to Vegas. He gonna continue to gamble online.
Can he go to Miami? Can he go to Miami now?
No. He ain't coming back to the United States.
Man, no. That man. What I do know is he ain't touching nothing on the West Coast. That's Phoenix, California, Oregon. Anything over there, he ain't touching it right now.
I thought he said he get more love in Compton than.
Let's see how much. Hey, Kendrick already told him Oakland to be your last stop.
I seen the videos in Oakland.
He just put all the houses up for sale.
Smoke in Oakland.
He what?
He just put all the houses up for sale.
Yeah,
he ain't coming back.
That man is not going to Cali. Nowhere near there.
Cool J said, I'm going back to Cali.
Ranch. He just bought a ranch in Texas. What you mean?
I don't think so.
All right. I said he ain't going nowhere west. He can come back to the
U.S. He just put all that stuff up for sale.
Well, look, this just like a topic. We try to talk about Rick Ross getting the beats put to him, Rick Ross getting belt the ass put to him, and now we end up talking about Drake.
That's just
the Drake effect.
Because Drake been getting belt to ass ever since he mentioned Kendrick's name.
Where?
Hey, he ain't let up off of him yet.
Where?
I ain't never been a fan of Drake.
Cause everything Drake said was a lie. Y'all wanted to get on Kendrick. Everything Drake said was lie. They said that man beat his wife. Man, his wife is crip walking.
He probably beat her in the video.
Listen, his wife is crip walking on Drake's face right now.
Well, let's get to it, because y'all don't want to talk about this. Let's get the
and he dropped the hot snippet.
Say he did something unexpected on his new music video, Not Like Us. Remember Drake said that he beefing with his fiance? Well, he put her in a video with his kids dancing. You have some people hyping it up, saying that Drake has officially lost because Kendrick and his wife are clearly happy while they're dancing in his music video, while other people are saying that it's hypocritical to have your biracial wife in a music video with you, but in that same song, you're talking down about people being biracial or being half black or etc. You also have people saying that this is the best music video to ever come out, that Drake can never compare to Kendrick, that Kendrick has officially won. Drake better not drop any more disses. Drake better not say anything. But then you have others stating that the video is not all that. Drake got something in store for him. Drake was just waiting on him to drop the music video. Regardless, what do you guys think about this situation? Crazy.
Wait, time out. That man made one mistake. That man made one mistake, and Joe had something to say. I thought Joe just did that to me, and light-skinned people know did it. But that man slipped one word and made one mistake, and Joe had something to say.
What he said? He stirred up,
and then he said, "Oh Lord, you are like you don't make mistakes, Joe."
No.
That little baby in Italy won a mistake.
It's a difference.
That little baby in Italy won a mistake.
It's a difference between a mistake and a choice.
Your but choice. You chose to leave that like baby in Italy.
I made a mistake and got her pregnant. No, you made a conscious decision to go up in a squirt and produce a baby. Now, if I swing a baseball bat and it slip out of my hand and hit somebody in the audience, then that was a mistake because I didn't plan to do that. But something that you conscious. We look to throw it on. I made a mistake. I made a mistake and I cheated on my wife. I made a mistake. It's a choice. It ain't a mistake.
I made a mistake.
I stepped on somebody's shoe.
He a fan.
He made a bad business decision.
This is the worst business decision Drake has ever made. Because he went at Meek Mill. Drake did everything that Kendrick is doing right now. Music videos, playing it, headlining concerts with that back-to-back disc. Baseball stadiums is opening up to back-to-back. All of these things that Drake did that all the Drake fans forget about, he came out on top. And he continued his run. Oh, but now he done ran into somebody that punch back and punch harder. Now it's played. Now, man, he just keep talking about the same thing. Drake done lied about everything he done said. He didn't show no proof of anything. He talked about Dave Free. Dave Free produced the concert. What's next? Oh, he beat his wife. His wife crip dancing in the video.
What that mean is Kendrick...
Did they not have
a hotel? People talking about.
Hey,
Kendrick put the paws on his old lady in the hotel.
Hey, I didn't see that. But did Kendrick not check off everything that Drake ever said? He checked off all along. Drake said
he lived in an apartment. Penthouse in Brooklyn.
And he probably did. Drake got houses that he got up for sale right now.
Everything he ever said.
I'm just saying. Well,
is he giving 50-50? Do you know?
Drake was so worried about another baby that he skipped all over him being called a pedophile and said,
Was that true?
And he said,
Drake having a little girl? Was that true?
What was true was when he said he fed information telling him he a pedophile and then going back and say, didn't nobody feed that information. He don't know where it came from.
Was it true when Kendrick said Drake had a little girl? Hey. When he made a stupid song talking to a person that didn't exist? Was that true?
Hey, shit.
Jebica, we ain't found
the baby yet. Don't mean it ain't true, cuz.
Hey, man. That's like, sometimes you can make a mistake. Like thanking your son ready for the NBA and he shoot 2-for-9. That's a mistake. See, so we gotta be able to correct that. Like then you got him selling the most jersey.
Oh my god.
These jabroni ass niggas.
Hey, his jersey per sale costs more than his goddamn shooting percentage stats. So sometimes you gotta stop selling garbage to the public. Talking about your son ready. It was USC. They wasn't a good fit. Well, you're supposed to be a genius, LeBron. I thought USC was synonymous for Heisman Trophy winners, and I don't remember a Heisman in basketball.
Drake can't even go to USC.
There you go. So we got to get rid of – when we cancel Drake, can we cancel Bronny with this foolishness? Now he come on at 5:30. I gotta watch this hot garbage so I can insult
the I thought LeBron was Drake's man. LeBron trying to run on the stage and crip walk too.
Yeah.
He was trying to run on stage and crip walk too.
Hey, he crip walking on Kendrick Lamar with the song. He left his son, abandoned him, went overseas, didn't want to watch him play live. So we gotta get
shout out DeMar DeRozan though.
I thought he was a friend of Drake.
Who, DeMar DeRozan?
Yeah.
Yeah, man, you know how y'all niggas.
LeBron ain't got no friends.
Look
what he did.
He's
from LA.
You know how y'all live. Man, Compton first. Listen, at the end of the day, it's okay for me to be friends with Joe and be friends with Champ. But come the championship, I'm going to choose a side. Is me? Will I beat them or will I let my friends win? Yeah.
Easy E, who you rocking with? Who you rocking with, champ? Easy E and Joe in a perfect
example.
Joe championship. What are you rocking with? Perfect example. Don't got to know championship. I'm rocking with Easy.
Appreciate it. Well, I told Easy ain't gonna win no more. He picked up Jamar Chase and had him in the three leagues, and I think in the Octagon, champ should have got in. One of the players been producing. He had that incredible Jamar Chase run. He will not win another championship. Period.
Who league is the Octagon?
Oh, that's KD over the NFL KD. League.
Oh, I'll be there. I'll be in there.
I don't think all the slots filled up.
It's I'm already in there.
Oh, you already in there? Okay, bet that.
I think I'm already in there.
$75 buy-in.
All right, y'all talk about that later. We better get out of here, man. DSN, I got out of here. After he waited over his time.
He had the better of the week.
Can I take your spot on that?
Yeah, go ahead.
Over and under.
Without saying LeBron, man.
Huh?
Without saying Brunny.
All right. When it comes to Savannah's oldest child. always go under. The only time you should bet over if they say that he won't last, that he will be in the league for 2 months. You can go over and say three. Do not bet on Savannah James Child, because guess what? Hot garbage. I said it.
The old man don't come into America. That was good.
One thing wrong with Bronny James, it's his game. It's his dad trying to make us believe he did.
He ain't lying.
That's the one. We're good. Coulter from upstairs.
I can't believe DFN came on here and told us he voted for the man over 8 points.
Shout out to LeBron James for giving me more to talk about when he retired.
Yeah, please no. I can't take it. No diddy. Clutch. Clutch. I'm out.
Yeah, baby.
Pistachio grapes and cheeses. It's pistachio grapes and cheeses, and I still don't smell nothing coming out of the kitchen. Probably put the meat back in the freezer. Clutch, give me a quote.
Oh, this is gonna be a short one today. Real short, to the point. You ready?
Yeah, they ready. I don't live my life by your quote.
All right.
I've been waiting all week. Go ahead.
Don't count the days. Make the days count.
Okay.
Right. I like it. That's like me and don't count the days till the college football video game come out. Make the days count. Like what, get what, in the what lab.
Count? Everybody
don't count the days. Don't count the days. The fantasy football draft. Make the days count. Yeah. Get in the lab. Do something for you don't end up with F grades like Joe. Hey. Why you just say something there, Clutch?
I made the playoffs and I got a championship with them F grade. What you trying to say, man?
Well, you know.
You still believe in some football, though.
Joe?
Huh?
You just said when you get divorced, don't count the alimony, count the movie fees.
That's it.
I'm back and go over there.
But Drake got Drake.
said to me.